welcome to this new Arabic lesson with me, Maha. Today I'm going to teach you some polite insults. Before I start showing you how to insult somebody politely, I want you to subscribe to my channel. Make sure also to turn on the notification bell. Please follow me on Instagram at Maha Yaqub and on my Facebook page at Learn Arabic with Maha. And in case you would like to become a member of this channel and have some member-only live streams, then I invite you to become a member and check all the rewards and perks that I'm offering you. Without further ado, let's begin with the lesson. I've been asked so much and so many times to teach you some insults, so here you go. One of the most insults that I use with my sisters, for example, is inqlaa. Inqlaa. Inqlaa is a verb, it's an imperative verb. It comes from aqlaa or inqalaa, because in the Palestinian dialect we don't pronounce the qa. We pronounce it ah. When we say أقلعت الطائرة, the airplane أقلعت, it departed, or like to take off. So when I tell you إنقلع or إنقلع, it's like take off. I'm telling you take off, but like get the hell out of my face. Take off إنقلع or إنقلع. It's written إنقلع. We'd never use it in the written form because that's not a standard Arabic word. That's a word or an expression used in the dialect, inqlaa, and if you're a female, inqlaa. Difficult to pronounce, so let's work on the pronunciation. Inqlaa, 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 and inqlaa. Inqlaa, inqlaa, inqlaa min wajhi. That's like another variation of it. Inqlaa, take off or get away, depart. Min wajhi, from my face, or even an wajhi. Try to change the preposition. Min and an work perfectly. Wajhi, it's my face. So in ilay min wajhi, in ilay an wajhi. Like get the hell away from my face, from me. Move, go away. That's the first polite insult for today's lesson. Another one is when you've been treating me bad and I'm pissed off with you, I can simply tell you khara alek. Khara alek. It's not a polite insult, by the way, but it's just like soft insults, let's call them. So khara alek means literally shit on you. Khara means shit, and alek, it's made out of two words, the preposition ala, which means on, and the k, the ek, at the ending, which means you. That's the object pronoun. Khara alek. It's like I'm really sad with you and I'm upset and I'm angry. Or it's like when you don't want to have anything to do with the person anymore. If you're a female, khara alayki. Khara alayk. Khara alayki. And khara alayko. All of you. Shit alayko. On you all. Khara alayk. I don't care. Khalas. Yalla. Khara alayk. Alright? That's our second insult for today. Then we have tuz fiik. Tuz fiik is incredibly used. Tuz is used, tuz, it's very difficult to translate or to explain. Tuz is a Turkish word, it's not an Arabic word. It was used by the Turkish officials who were asking from the Arab merchants some kind of tax over the merch that they were trying to sell. I read it this way. Tuz in Turkish, it means salt, okay? Tuz is salt. Now, when the Arab merchants would pass with these bags of tuz of salt, in order just to tell them that it's not something that I should pay taxes on to the officials, it's just simply tuz. So it became like just tuz, it's just tuz, it's not something that is worth anything. So tuz alek, nothing, something that's worth nothing, alek, on you. So you're really worthless and I don't care about you. That's why it's an expression of indifference, like I really don't care. Tuz alek. It's also an insult, like I'm giving you something that's worth, I'm telling you you're worthless and I really don't care about anything good that happens to you, but simply tuz alek. Tuz alek, I'm fed up with you and I don't want anything to do with you and I consider you to not be worth my time. Tuz, tuzin talati. That's another expression that the Arabs created. Tuz, tuzin talati. Tuz, not only one tuz, but two tuz, tuzin. And talati and three tuz. So I'm not giving you only one tuz. You're not worth anything. Not even tuz salt. Tuzin and three. Talati tuz. All right. Anyway, please don't
like really don't think about it too much because these are expressions from the spoken language and our dialect is super super rich with these expressions. You don't have to take everything literally and it's very difficult to explain everything literally. Even I told you like this story of those vaguely and just generally, but try to understand when we use these expressions and maybe like the, not the literal meaning but the meaning in general of when to use them. Okay, I'm treating you with indifference. I'm mad, upset, but I'm not telling you go F yourself. I'm telling you, I don't want anything. Don't want anything to do with you. طز علي, right? Like pissed on you or something like this. All right. So the next one, it's very similar to انقلع, take off and get the hell away from my face. We say انصرف. Very similar, same meaning, almost same meaning. انصرف. Same thing works with female. انصرفي. And with all of you, انصرفوا. انصرفوا من وجهي. انصرفوا. طب انصرف انصرفي. Like, I'm sending you away. انصرف. Another one is very literal, similar to these. It's امشي من هون. امشي من هون. امشي. Literally, it's an imperative and it is the verb مشى, to walk. So امشي, you walk. Walk من هون. From here. Walk from here. Like, walk away. I don't want to see you anymore. امشي من هون. That's like why I considered it a polite insult. Another one that is a little bit stronger than امشي من هون, move from here, غور من وجهي. غور again, like get the hell away. That's like the literal translation of غور. Just like انقلع, just like اقبع, and just like انصرف. غور. But then there's a continuation. غور من وجهي. غور من وجهي again. من from and وجهي is my face. وجه is face or وجهي my face. So غور من وجهي. غور من وجهي. Get the hell away from me. Right? Another one that is very similar. It's انقبر. 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 It's also an imperative verb and it literally means go bury yourself. قبر is the grave. انقبر. It's a reflexive verb, imperative reflexive verb. So you go put yourself under the grave or bury yourself. That's انقبر. So انقبر, انقبر, انقبر. انقبري if you're a female and انقبرو if you're a lot of people. I'm not giving you examples because I don't, there is no need for examples on when to use the insult. I don't want to put you in situations, but I'm just trying to translate them to you and to show you how severe they are. My favorite ever insult, it's حل عن طيزي. حل عن طيزي. حل عن طيزي can be a synonym of انقلع, انصرف, انقبر, all of these like get away from my face. But I'm not telling you غور من وجهي, get away from وجهي, my face. I'm telling you حل عن طيزي. حل عن is exactly like the same meaning of get away from. حل عن is like leave alone this thing that's coming next. طيزي. حل عني, for example, حل عني, get away from E, which means me. حل عني. It's also a nice way to insult somebody. حل عني. حل عني. Go away from me. Leave me alone. Let me or leave me alone. That's حل. حل means like detach. Detach yourself from me. Get the hell away from me. حل عني. But what I was telling you about my favorite expression, it wasn't حل عني. It was حل عن. So detach yourself from. Or leave alone. My what? طيزي. طيزي. It means ass. Yeah. A-S-S. طيزي. Everything that I end it with E becomes mine. So حل عن طيزي. Detach yourself from my طيزي. Or get the hell away. Not from وجهي. But from my طيزي. Get away. Get the hell away from my ass. It's really ugly to say it in English. And it's ugly to translate even. Because in Arabic, it's not that. We're not using a bad word again. And the word طيزي is not that, you know, a scandal to say طيزي. I love this expression. Because it's like, I'm really fed up with you. بس خلاص. حل عن طيزي. Like, leave me alone. Leave me please alone. حل عن طيزي. I love it a lot. I even taught it in one of my classes. Because I was really begged. Ma, teach us something that would insult somebody else. I chose حل عن طيزي to teach it. And I love it. And I say it a lot.
Of course, not to my daughter, but I say it a lot when I'm fed up with my sisters, for example. If somebody's insisting, I would simply tell her, "Hello, auntie," like, leave me alone, "Hello, auntie," without really, like, not trying to insult her. So yeah, this is a list of some bad insults that I decided to teach you today. You asked for it, so don't insult me down there with the fact that I taught you this lesson. I tried to be as mild and as soft as possible, teaching you only the ones that really are to the point. They describe how you're feeling, you were fed up and you're angry with something, without using really ugly words, okay? We have really bad insults in the Arab world, just like in all the languages in the world, but I'm not gonna teach those. I'm going to restrict myself or to refrain from teaching those. I taught you these ones that are super, super used in a daily life in cases where you're really tired and angry and fed up and you want to insult somebody without using the harsh ones. All right, I hope you like this lesson. If you like it, comment below and subscribe to this channel for more Arabic lessons, maybe better Arabic lessons than the insult or the bad words Arabic lesson. And I will see you in a following one. Thank you for my patrons for supporting me and my project. Thank you so much. And if you want to become my patron, please check my Patreon page here and you can learn about my project. I also updated my memberships. If you want to become a member of this channel, you're welcome. Click on the join button and you can know what are the rewards and the perks that I'm offering you by becoming a member of this channel. Thank you for watching again. I kiss you and ma salama.